Sound check, 1, 2. So, you know, hindi ko alam kung bakit ganun palagi yung intro ng mga vloggers, no? So, ayun po, ano? So, you know, so, ito nga pala, no? Nagmana ba tayo kay Kong TV? Pero yun na nga, kidding aside, we're back here in my hideout. And yun, just to share with you, I had an experiment. Ilang buwan na yung nakalipas. Yung experiment na yun was a 30-day social media detox. From the title of the experiment itself, talagang 30 days wala akong social media. And yun ang ginawa ko. Well, I was able to document the process. Pero hindi ko natapos yung editing. And since right now, nagkaroon ako ng time to edit this. So, panoorin natin.
I really strongly believe that social media is the next great addiction. Smoking, alcohol, gambling, social media is right up there. Because you get the same response. You get the same dopamine responses when you're liking things, sharing things, whatever people are liking and commenting, as you do with drugs and alcohol.
Everybody I know does it. You know, it's kind of a popularized thing, the idea of like going down an internet rabbit hole where you're reading an article or you're writing something like, oh, I just need to look this up. And then you find like 30 minutes has passed and you're like, how the hell did I end up on this website? Where did, like, I went down a rabbit hole.
My entire identity was tied to who I was online, and I felt like if I didn't post or I wasn't there, it was like I wasn't even doing anything interesting. I wasn't an interesting person.
Oh, hi there. I did a 30-day social media detox. I am now convinced that excessive social media and phone usage is a criminal. It's a thief because it steals the most important thing in our lives, which is time. Let me ask you a question. Have you ever felt that you don't have enough time to do all the things that you want to do in your life? Or you don't have enough time to catch up with the people you value the most or you love the most? Or take it personally, you don't have enough time to take care of yourself. I felt that. And I asked myself, what can I do in order for me to do all the things that I wanted to do? Hence, the experiment. So this idea started when I realized that I'm not having enough sleep. I feel tired at work early in the morning. I don't have enough energy to work. And I just really feel bad of myself. And I know I needed help. That's why I bought this audiobook, Digital Minimalism by Cal Newport.
Much like decluttering your house, this lifestyle experiment provides a reset for your digital life by clearing away distracting tools and compulsive habits that may have accumulated haphazardly over time and replacing them with a much more intentional set of behaviors, optimized in proper minimalist fashion to support your values instead of subverting them.
So before I start this experiment, I wanted to know some numbers. I sleep on an average of 5.5 hours. I have zero alone time with my own thoughts. That's why I don't have anything that is written in my journal. I have a total of 5 gym visits and a total of 7 hours of screen time a day. So knowing those numbers, I started this experiment by creating rules. No Instagram. No Facebook. No YouTube. I schedule my usage of Messenger, Viber, and email from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. no phones while eating. To help me with this experiment, I needed another help. Flip phone. So basically, this one is the one that I will use in order for me to communicate offline. Since until 7 PM lang ako with my Messenger, Viber, and email, all of work-related stuffs that I needed to know goes here. To balance things out, I'm aware also that social media and technology in general is a great help in this generation. Well, basically, it helps us connect easier and faster to our friends, to our families that are far away from us and have those meaningful conversations. But, well, every excessive usage of anything is the one that is bad. Uy, ha, good morning. Yesterday was my day one of digital detox. So technically, kagabi, pag uwi ko ng bahay ng 7, automatically wala na akong Messenger, Viber, and emails. So technically, this phone that I'm using was useless. Since wala din naman dito yung SIM ko, I'm not able to use mobile data with this phone. Even Wi-Fi is technically useless kasi wala na akong apps na ina-open dito unless I wanted to listen to a podcast or an audiobook, pero I didn't do it. Pag-uwi ko, itong phone na to, tinapon ko sa, as in ginanong ko sa kama ko. Isa sa resulta na napansin ko with this detox is that na-reclaim ko yung oras ng tulog ko. I slept for 7 hours. Day 1 pa lang, I feel great, so I'm expecting more. With this experiment, I unconsciously created a routine. I go to work. Work out after work. Go home and sleep. And during day offs, I leave the house because I might get distracted with Wi-Fi. So I go to Starbucks and then I journal. If I have more time, I work out and then go home and sleep. With this routine, I have successfully replaced my social media time from time of isolation in the virtual world to literally personal time. In the middle of this experiment, I had a chance to go to our province and disconnect to the busy city life. Okay, so today is day 17. And today, nasa province ako. Actually, second day namin ngayon dito sa province. Well, it's a good thing na andito nga ako sa probinsya dahil limited ang access sa internet. So, basically, ang daming napakagandang pwedeng gawin like magpahinga. With this quick vacation, all I did is to rest. And also some alone time. So ayun, hanggang dun lang yung inabot ng editing ko at that time. One reason is because I wasn't able to document the latter part because nagkasakit ako. Well, I stick to the experiment. Hindi ko lang talaga siya vlinag kasi mas inalala ko yung kalusugan ko at the same time yung current work ko at that time. Baka mas lalo kasi akong magkasakit if madami akong gagawin. That's why. And looking back to that experiment, it was one of my best 30 days in my life. With that experiment, ang dami kong natutunan. Number one is the novelty of being alone. Yung tipong hindi mo kailangan ng internet para maging masaya. Instead of scrolling in social media, I'm doing something else na gives value to my life. Yun, ang sarap sa feeling nun. I get to journal, I get to write my plans. So it was a good takeaway after the detox process. Another one is reclaiming my sleep time. At that time kasi, I'm spending an average of 3 hours of commute from home to work and work to home. Critical sa akin at that time yung sleep time kasi biruin mo, aside from the 9 hours na nasa work ako, that includes my break time, dadagdagan ko pa ng 3 hours of commute. So, that's a total of 12 hours. Kalahating araw na. So, if ide-deprive ko pa yung sarili ko with sleep, baka mas mapagod lang ako through the process. Which, napagod talaga ako before my experiment. So, that experiment really helped me to really manage my time, especially with my sleep. So, I had an average of 7 to 8 hours of sleep. And then, I am more happy at work kasi alam ko maganda yung tulog ko. So, mas productive ako. At the same time, mas masaya mag-work. With my gym visits, yun nga, like I said, nagkasakit ako right after my quick vacation sa province. So, instead of me pushing myself to go to gym, I just spend my time resting. So, kesa naman just for the vlog, eh mas madami yung gym visits ko. Ayoko namang gawin yun, diba? So, half of the time, nagpahinga ako. Pero at least, mas maganda yung quality of gym ko. Kasi, I get to go to the gym kahit na wala akong dalang phone. Overall, during and after the detox, I can say na I am more happy compared to myself before the experiment. Why? Knowing that I can be happy without social media. Knowing that I can communicate to my friends without social media. That's a win-win. At the same time, mas nakakatulog ako na mas mahimbing. Diba? And after, mas na-evaluate ko ano ba yung mas kailangan ko sa internet. Is it social media itself or other things? So mas naging conscious ako right after the experiment with in terms of my usage of the internet and social media. So yun, that was the 30-day social media detox. I hope that na-inspire kayo with the experiment that I had. And I hope you consider nyo din na you take a break with social media and the internet. Kasi the benefits of it, sobrang approve ako. So, yun lang. Bye-bye.